Hi, I'm Angela from the product marketing team at Sentry, here to talk to you about how to get up and running with user feedback. While Sentry can automatically detect unhandled exceptions, poor performance, and even signals of user frustration, such as rage clicks, there are some problems that only a human can identify. This is where Sentry's new user feedback widget can help. It's available out of the box on all plans for free. Sentry's user feedback widget allows users to send you feedback when they encounter an issue on your site, and those feedback submissions will be linked to rich debugging context in Sentry, such as associated replays, errors, and even the device they were on. To set up the user feedback widget, navigate to the User Feedback tab in your Sentry org, select the relevant web frontend project, and simply click on Setup Now. By default, the form asks for name, email, and the user's message. If you want either name or email to be required, you can toggle them on, which updates the code snippet. For this example, I will make email required. If you already collect the name and email address of end users via the SDK, the feedback integration will attempt to fill in the name and email fields for you. At this point, you want to copy the code snippet into your site. You can adjust the feedback widget to match your site's design. For example, on my demo site, I can update the color of the Submit button with the Submit background key to fit the theme of the rest of my site, as well as some tweaks to the button hover state and border. There's a ton of customization options available. You can adjust the text you see, change colors of the background, borders, focus states, just about everything to fit your site's look and feel. The default button is a floating one in the bottom right-hand corner. However, depending on your website, that might not be ideal. You can bring your own button and place it anywhere on your site, such as in your header. Once you've customized the feedback widget to your liking, you're all set. To ensure you get alerted every time a user submits feedback, go to Alerts in Sentry and create a new issue alert. Make sure you set the issue category as feedback in the if condition. In the then condition, you can set your preferred actions, such as sending feedback alerts to a specific Slack channel. Congrats! You're now all set and ready to receive your first feedback submission. And if you have session replay enabled, you will see it embedded in the feedback submission if there's one available.